is ESP real? The answer that most parapsychologists will give you is ESP happens. We observe it in the lab.
What happens when you play by all of the rules of science, but find something that could not possibly be there?
We take two people and we separate them in two different rooms. In one room, we have a person who is considered the receiver. Their eyes are covered, their ears have white noise playing in it, and they speak stream of consciousness about whatever comes to mind. In the other room, the sender is watching a video and trying to send information to the receiver in the other room.
There was one particular person, got 25 in a row.
I heard a saying that parapsychology is the control group for science.
Clairvoyance.
Telepathy.
Psychokinesis.
The idea is that if you want to see if you're doing good science, you should compare yourself to ESP research and make pretty darn sure you're doing better than they are. And the reason is that parapsychology is not supposed to be good science. You just can't reproduce original results over the long run without having to explain away failures over and over again. I wanted to see this for myself, to compare good science with bad science. So I started looking. And what I found wasn't pretty.
In every place that reproducibility has been examined, there are challenges of reproducing original results. It's not psychology, it's not social sciences, it's not life sciences, it's everywhere that it's been investigated.
We all know that if you report data selectively, you will be able to find evidence for any hypothesis you want.
When people have a randomized experiment, they think they have validity, and that's not really right.
If you go out in nature and you observe things, you're describing the way nature actually works. If you do experiments, you come up with a contrived system, which is obviously artificial. And so, yeah, you get some results, but you never know how much those results are actually applicable to nature.
Everybody's Albert Einstein. Every new study is something which is proven. It's both theoretically supported and a big shock.
Coming up this season on Hi-Fi Nation, Hackademics. We look at science at the fringes.
Cherry picking, p-hacking.
What makes for good science, bad science, or no science at all?
And parapsychologists are scientists.
We look at the recent scientific attempts at reforming science from the inside and ask ourselves, what are we, the public, supposed to believe when we hear stories about new provocative findings in academic and medical research? Subscribe now on iTunes for the first season of Hi-Fi Nation, coming to you January 24th.